एवरीवन, मोस्ट ऑफ द पीपल टू मच सीरियस अबाउट मी, बिकॉज आई एम आस्किंग होम ऑल, दैट्स व्हाई. नेक्स्ट टाइम एनी चांस इज देयर, इफ यू डोंट लाइक मी यू विल मैच दैट टू सम अदर बैच, अनदर टीचर विल कम, यू डोंट वरी दैट वन, इफ यू डोंट लाइक आवर क्लास. We'll see that one soon. Because you are not responding anything, whatever you are asking. No, most other people, they don't like it, I think so. Can exchange, otherwise just when they're asking me then you can exchange. Only sir will take your class, then I will try to take that is if you don't like this. Okay, fine. So everyone came now, joined. Okay, fine. Actually, I don't know that Preeti, that's fine. Then reply me once you join properly, your attentive nature now, then you can start our class. I thought everyone is there in the number here. I am seeing that one, everyone in the class, but I don't know that when you are not allowed to chat or something, previous host is there. So if you joined everyone, we can start our class. Whenever you join means just be in active mode in our class. Our chemistry class, I never heard that one, chemistry is boring class. Even freshly they came 11 student also, even if people are seniors also, you know that one, I never hear that word still now. If you are not active mode means I need to think, that's only then. Fine. I think so. Last class I given cations. Is it correct? I hope you noted down these cations. Next, anions also you can note down. This is discharging potential decreasing order. Preferential discharge potential decreasing order, sir. Preferential discharge potential decreasing order. Please note down preferential discharge potential decreasing order. Above one is for cations decreasing order, This is for anions. Please note down both. Now, who noted down? Please remember Asti's order, sir. Who noted down? Please remember Asti's order. I am giving few minutes time. Please note down. Cations and anions. Please note down. Asti's order we need to note down. Remember. So remember which is right side is there. First they will discharge. Left side can discharge later. Right, discharge meaning what is that one, sir? Loss of charge. Yes or no? Charge removing. Discharge means charge removing. So at electrodes, charge removing takes place. At electrodes, that is cathode or anode, doesn't matter. Ultimately, after reaction at cathode and anode, we'll get neutral part. Neutral. At electrode, discharge takes place. At electrode, discharge takes place. Electrolytic cell only given. After that, please write code. Okay, last class we discuss. I was just continuing only. We didn't do anything here. See, I'm explaining what the connectivity they given. Now, by things I given here, suppose one cell I'm taking. This is two electrodes. Is connected to wires. It contains solution. That suppose aqueous NaCl, I took that one. If you are doing electrolysis of aqueous NaCl, it will dissociate. Na plus Cl minus. It will give Na plus and Cl minus. Aqueous means water also is there. H2O gives rise H plus OH minus. Is it correct? So at anode reduction, sorry, at anode oxidation, at cathode reduction. But two cations is there. And two anions is there, which is undergo oxidation and which is undergo reduction, we have to calculate. To avoid this confusion, we have one theory, that is preferential preferential discharge potential theory. Preferential discharge potential theory. According to this theory, right sir, according to this theory, when two or more ions present at electrodes, the ion with lowest discharge potential that lowest charge potential discharged first at that electrode. Please note down these two line center. Completed, let me know that one completed. So please note down only two lines, little bit fast you can note down. Do you know that one? News readers are what a journalist people. Even you know when politician or whatever that is actor, they're talking. Even they let them they talk. They can note down very fast. Okay. So at least you are not like that. At least one or two times I'm repeating, you can note down a little bit fast. Fine. After this, note it down. Come to the back. Right. Decreasing order of, right there, siding, sir. Decreasing order of preferential discharge potential. Decreasing order of order of preferential discharge potential. For cations, write it. For cations, decreasing order meaning you know that highest to lowest are decreasing. So write as is order and try to remember. K plus have more potential and AU 3 plus are this is AU. AU 3 plus have least discharge potential. Please write it. So which is the least discharge potential that will discharge first or that will deposit at electrodes. So once you noted down this line, let me know that one. Yes, AU 3 plus, AU 3 plus. So, out of these cations, which can first discharge, sir? You can write, sir. AU 3 plus discharge first. And last going to be K plus can discharge. This order. For example, hydrogen and sodium is there. Which is going to discharge first? H plus and Na plus. Which can discharge first? H plus, Na plus is there. Which can discharge first? H plus. Correct. And suppose Cu2 plus and H plus is there. Which can discharge first? Cu2 plus and H plus. Which can discharge first? Cu2 plus. Understood this point? What is the meaning of this order? After I've given ions, which can discharge first? I have discharge meaning again very clearly. There should be loose charge by gaining electrons only chance. Similarly, for anion, sir, preferential discharge potential for anion. Note down this order also. So first can discharge I minus. Note down as this order. Well, try to remember order as it is. Now I am going to be asking you questions. So you need to give answers. Don't think that one I can remember later at home. These dialogues, remove that one, the dialogues. Next point. After that, you make a note down oxoanions. Right, sir. Next, oxoanions. Please write. Oxoanions. Make a note on this list of that oxoanions. Are oxoanions nothing but which one have more number of oxygens? Which one have more number of oxygen anions? This corresponding acids we called oxoacids. H2SO4, H3PO4, all these are oxo acids. Means they should have more number of oxygen, more than one or two oxygens. Okay, more than one, those acids. These are oxo acids. HNO3, H2CO3, HClO4. All they have more than one oxygen atoms in the acids. Those we call oxo acids. Corresponding anions is oxoanions. Corresponding anions is called oxoanions. Completed. Oxoacids and oxoanions. Any acid that contain more than one oxygen atom, those we call generally oxoacids, and corresponding anions is oxoanions. Means they can show resonance structures. Sir, this can show resonance structures. Right, generally oxoanions do not discharge at electrodes. Please write that note. You can write, sir. Generally oxoanions do not discharge at electrodes. Generally, oxoanions do not discharge at electrodes. Done that point? Generally, oxoanions do not discharge at electrodes. The reason very simple, okay? Maybe we need to discharge more potential required. Otherwise, you arrange that setup in electrodes that is not sufficient to do this work. Suppose these are the electrodes is there. We are taking ions. When they have to discharge here sulfate ions, we need to provide either more energy or more potential, which we are taking setup that is may not be suitable for to discharge that one. Or if you are supplying more potential, the sulfate may can dissociate into pieces. So that is destroying that everything. So now write one more point also. This under note only you can write, sir. Next point. Discharge potential theory applicable for in presence of inert electrodes. In presence of inert electrodes. Preferential discharge potential theory applicable in presence of inert electrodes. Next point, please note down. This preferential discharge potential theory applicable in presence of inert electrode. Inert meaning that won't be react, sir. Here I given definition. Types of electrodes you make a note down if you want. Types of electrodes you make a note down right now. Electrode means I given here diagram also. You make and check it, sir. Which is I'm using cathode and anode is generally electrode. Which is cathode and anode we are using. Electrode. This is not reacting with which you are taking solution here. You may can take that solution is cathode means NaCl, whatever that is. That is not reacting with these electrodes. Those we called inert electrodes. Inert electrode means types of electrodes. You may can try it. So these electrodes not react with electrolytic solution is called anode electrodes. Example PT electrodes are platinum is the electrode. Active electrolytes means these electrodes can react with electrolytic solution. For example, copper electrode in copper sulfate solution, zinc electrode in ZnSO4 solution. I will explain everything, you don't worry that one. Okay. So first we done this point. Preferential discharge potential theory applicable in presence of inert electrodes only. First point you noted down. Preferential discharge potential theory applicable in presence of inert electrodes only. That point you noted down. Any doubt that point? I will explain. Still explanation is not completed. I know that one. I will explain. So what is the inert electrode means? Which you are taking any solution that won't react with that electrode, sir. This is the electrodes we called. You can see this diagram, sir. If these electrodes is not reacting, which is I am taking in the solution, that may be NaCl or KCl, anything. That solution and electrode should not react each other. That's we called inert electrodes. And example platinum electrode. Active electrode means you make and take, sir. Zinc electrode. This is the rod I am taking. Zinc rod. In ZnSO4 solution, zinc can participate in the reaction. Zn gives rise Zn2 plus plus 2 electrons. This is the active electrodes. In this platinum electrode, platinum gives rise platinum 2 plus plus electrons, like that. This doesn't happen. So platinum is not participating in the reaction. That's why this inert electrode. But active electrodes means which you are taking rod that can participate in the reaction. That's we call active electrodes. What is active electrodes meaning? Active electrodes means itself meaning, sir. It can participate in the reaction. Inert electrode means it doesn't participate in the reaction. Okay, Ganesh, you note it down. Now, whatever you done till now, that's where going to be applied. Clear? So now, freshly we can take. Please remember that orders cation and anion. Now you have to remember. Please look into that orders. Try to remember. Remember means now only you can complete our concept. You don't want to learn later. A given time to remember. Please do that work. First question, sir. Electrolysis of aqueous NaCl in presence of inert electrode, inert electrodes. Inert electrodes. Okay, so means that setup you make an imagine. This is electrodes, cathode and anode. You make an imagine that is. then this is the solution is aqueous NaCl. That is we called electrolyte. What is the reaction at anode? What is the reaction at cathode? You have to decide. I hope already yesterday I given reaction at anode oxidation. Is it correct? Anode oxidation takes place. Same reaction at cathode, reduction takes place. These 2 points everyone you need to remember. So NaCl means it can dissociate Na plus Cl minus N. This is aqueous means water also is there, that is H2O, sir. H2O gives rise H plus Cl minus. Sorry, OH minus. H plus OH minus. So which ion going to be discharged? Or you have to know that one, cathode reduction, anode is oxidation. Here two cations, two anion is there. Which one undergo oxidation and reduction you have to identify. So Na plus H plus, which is going to be discharged? H plus. Look into order, everyone. You can look into that order, cation discharge potential theory, then give your answers. And what about Cl minus and OH minus, which is going to be participate? Again, look into order. We don't want to do anything, sir. From order only we are getting. Very simple way we are going to discuss, sir. Very easy, all these things. So Cl minus can discharge. So now that reactions you are writing, how to write that reactions? You may have doubts. Already you know that one starting point. Generally at electrodes, discharge takes place. If you don't know, again, you can note down, sir. At electrodes, discharge takes place. Discharge means charge should be loose. For example, at cathode. At cathode. At cathode reduction or oxidation, which one takes place? At cathode reduction or oxidation, sir? Reduction. Reduction means gaining of electrons or loss of electron. Reduction means gain of electrons or loss of electron. Gain of electrons. Which can gain electrons? Cations or anions? Which can gain electrons? Which can gain electrons? Cation or anion? Array, which one have positive charge, that only require electrons. Negative, negative, they can't attract. Very simple logic. Negative, negative, repulsions. Positive, negative, only they can attract. So which is positive here? Na plus and H plus. Which is going to take place out of these two? H plus only going to deposit. You know that one. You only given answers. So H plus you can take. Plus one electron gives rise. That become H. But H is never exist. That H we are writing half H2, sir. Or anywhere gases, they won't exist like this one. You can write this is half H2 also. Because this 2 and 2 will be cancelled, again H only will come. That's why you can write half H2 gas. So that is correct. A reason half of will be cancelled, again H only will come. This is at cathode reaction. At anode. At anode is oxidation. Oxidation means loss of electrons. Please note down that point. Cl minus, OH minus, which is preferred? Cl minus. Cl minus. Loss of electrons means you should be lose that electrons. Plus electrons. Now check it. But Cl is again, alone they won't exist. That's why I'm writing half Cl2. Half Cl2. Got it? Which is understood, please note down in the form of sentence also. why you are choosing only H plus other than Na plus. That reason you can note down. Then how did you write H plus at cathode reaction? Then why you are writing H2 of H2 also? Everything which you understood, you can write in the form of sentence. Then only you can remember, and you can give one more question answer. Just a representation I wrote. I'm talking about how we equal H equal to half H2. Suppose we are asking, there is a process I given. Suppose I have out of how one H equal to half H2. If they are asking, then only this type of things. Otherwise, you can write directly half H2. I'm equaling that one. You may feel, na, sir, how that is equal to half H2. In that situations, I'm going to be show that one. Is that not cancel, sir? Maybe that by mistakenly that. Came okay. So these are not cancelled. Please note down that is half H2 is correct. Please note down half H2 and half Cl2. And write net reaction. Net reaction means you need to add that one both. So add both, sir. Net reaction H plus plus Cl minus. Electron will be cancelled, which is opposite direction. Electron is left side of the arrow. Here right side of the arrow. We can cancel, sir, everything. Gives rise half H2 plus half Cl2. Yes, sir. Cell reaction. Net reaction is a cell reaction. Any other doubt, please? You can ask. We'll take, sir. We'll take. We'll discuss that is. Galvanic cell is the separate, that is, you may can say scientist name, whatever, but we are taking process is same. But cathode anode reactions, yeah, cathode and anode, different elements you are taking, then that name came. Who invited first like that? Or if you understand this process, you can do for any reaction, sir, any reaction yourself. And I am teaching process, we don't want by head anything separate cell. Any reaction let them give, we can do up to higher level. No, that is next question. Okay, we are not cancelling. Up to this, everyone understood? Please, can you note down here under note? Net reaction, is there any electrons? Net reaction, is there any electrons? Please, you can check it. Are Nagarjun, we are learning all the subject properly. You don't worry that one. Everything we will cover. So already I told you very first class, my teaching is up to 1-2 top 10 rank. Only NCERT book suppose we are getting. 7th, 8th standard only up to 10th standard. NCERT book, too many students overall India, they studied it more than 20 times. So now we are learning NCERT book first time, but already these students, 7th, 9th, 8th, 10th, only they are studying NCERT book too many times. You can ask any corner point, they will give. But still, they are not getting first rank. Okay. then how can you expect we people can achieve that one by studying only NCERT? So NCERT by studying you can qualify 200% whatever your requirement is there, but we are studying means trying top 10 ranks means we need to get a little bit more conceptually. Okay, try to understand. I'm giving for you maximum or best. Only my target is to completion of syllabus means I can do very fast according to your NCERT. I can do very fast. Even within 2 days, one lesson we can close. But my interest, you have to learn subject. After my classes, we have to see chemistry is different view, not like regular view. And even you may can see that one different, you will get easily difference between my chemistry class and other subject classes. We are not teaching like just formality to complete syllabus. I try to enjoy that one. Fine. So you can write it. Net reaction, is there any electrons? Is there any electrons net reaction? Can you write? Same thing. Net reaction should not contain electrons. Please write sir that point. Net reaction should not contain electrons. Read the statement. Net reaction should not contain electrons. So whenever you are writing anywhere net reaction, that should not contain electrons. If you are getting electrons means you didn't balance that equation properly. Understood? And everything we are proving by our experience only. Okay. Just by giving equation, we are proving everything. So understood? Up to this, anything doubt? Are this is your neat question, sir. Up to this, what is the anode product, cathode product over? Now little bit we can understand more. After electrolysis, what is the ions remaining here? Cl minus is gone, H plus is gone. What is the remaining ions? NaOH. What is the solution we are taking? Aqueous NaCl. Aqueous NaCl pH value is 7. What about during electrolysis? pH values. pH become more than 7, sir. So pH increases. Can note that point. After electrolysis of aqueous NaCl, pH of the solution increases due to formation of NaOH. So this is the example to prepare NaOH also. In 11th standard, we have that one. Daniel cell something is there. So NaOH preparation. You can prepare by using this method NaOH also. So due to aqueous NaCl hydrolysis, pH of the solution increases. Yes, yes, everywhere you have to balance like redox reactions only. Electrochemistry nothing but redox reaction only. Completed. You noted of that point. pH of the solution increases or decreases after electrolysis of aqueous NaCl. pH is increases. Next question, sir. Now try your answers. If you are not getting, I will give, sir. And I note down, generally OH minus discharge I am giving, sir. H2O plus half O2 plus 2 electrons. OH minus discharging. OH minus discharge. You can balance all the electrons. If Br minus discharge means, you can write half Br2 plus electron. All these are reactions at anode or cathode. All these reactions at anode or cathode? Anode. Very good. Anode, sir. Because oxidation of electrons. or loss of electrons is a anode reaction. Loss of electrons. Now write question. Do electrolysis of aqueous CuSO4 solution, sir. Electrolysis of aqueous CuSO4. Aqueous CuSO4. So first you need to write CuSO4 dissociate. Cu2 plus plus SO4 2 minus. Whenever they are given, first you can note down like this. Aqueous means water. We can add after that. Now think about that orders. This is in presence of inert electrodes, sir. In presence of inert electrodes only. After electrolysis, what is the cathode product, anode product, the right reactions? Write our notes very clearly, then we'll discuss. So final solution is acidic or basic. How to write discharge reactions? You may can see last class, I mean last example I explained. Again I will discuss clearly. Please look into here. So Cu2 plus discharging, you know that one. At cathode. Cathode reduction or oxidation, you know that one very well. Please remember cathode reduction, which is Cu2 plus. Discharge means how many electrons required, sir? Because 2 plus is there, that's why 2 electrons required. Get Cu and at anode. So already mentioned only OH minus is going to discharge. Before this example, I mentioned that is H2O plus half O2 plus 2 electrons. This is at anode reaction, net reaction. Just add both, sir. Cu2 plus plus. OH minus use rise plus U plus half O2 is a net reaction because two electrons will be cancelled. After electrolysis, H2SO4 is the remainder. So H plus is remaining, SO4 remaining. There is nothing but H2SO4. H2SO4 means this is acidic character. So pH of the solution decreases. Decreases. Any doubt? Please get any doubt. Rishki respond, remaining people also, not only very few people responding. What about remaining people, sir? There is no negative marks, huh? You can respond. Understood this concept? One example I'm giving, make and try it. Electrons, all these are electrodes. Okay. Aqueous MgCl2. Aqueous MgCl2. Right, as is reactions. This is for practice purpose. Question is common, sir, in presence of inert electrodes. Try it. If you are not getting, I will give answer.
अंत
मैगूड चावल वस्ते completed. Fine. So doesn't matter, right? Yes. Mg2 plus plus 2C minus. Aqueous means water is there. H plus OH minus. So which is going to be discharged at cathode and anode, sir? Cathode reduction. Choose which cation is better one, H plus or Mg2 plus. At anode, Cl minus and OH minus, sir. remaining is magnesium hydroxide. This is basic nature. So pH is going to be increases. Here if you want you can take one electron also, correct, but highly preferred is half only, sir. Half H2 and half Cl is the highly preferred. I wrote balance equation, both I multiplied, but highly preferred is one electron is the highly preferred. One electron is highly preferred. Done? Any doubt? So friends of active electrode, sir, you can see. Okay, suppose electrolysis of CuSO4 solution in presence of active electrode. Nothing but copper electrode, sir. So we are taking active electrode. Here also count is CuSO4, X solution will be there. Cu2 plus plus SO4 2 minus, and H2 also will be there. That also will associate H plus OH minus. So at anode, first you can take cathode is better, you can understand easily. Cathode, sir. Cathode anyway, Cu2 plus plus 2 electrons gives rise. At anode oxidation, which is active electrode, means it going to be participate in the reaction, sir. So copper electrode only will lose electrons. At anode oxidation, you will get here CuSO4 plus 2 electrons. Who lost electrons here? Can you identify? Copper zero oxidation state, here plus 2 oxidate, 2 electrons, copper lost electrons. So CuSO4 again, that will dissociate anyway, Cu2 plus plus SO4 2 minus. Net reaction, anode is net reaction, Cu2 gives Cu2 plus plus 2 electrons. So this oxidation or not oxidation, this is the net reaction at anode. Net reaction at anode.